Macmillan Audio presents Seeds of Deception by Linda Castillo. Read for you by Kathleen McInerney. Zimmerman's orchard was the last place 14-year-old Katie Burkholder wanted to be, especially with her older brother Jacob. He was bossy and about as fun as a milk cow, one that kicked. But Mam had insisted. She needed 6 bushels of apples for pies and apple butter, both of which she planned to sell. Katie had already finished the sign Dot would post at the end of their lane. Homemade apple butter, $3.99. Dutch apple pies, $5.99. No worms, her mam had told them as they walked out the door, and keep your sister out of trouble. She just had to add that last line, as if there was trouble to be found in an orchard. Mam was probably still angry with her. 2 nights ago, Katie had been caught reading, huddled beneath her covers, using the flashlight she'd bought for a buck at the drugstore. The reading itself wasn't the problem, but the material was. It was the book her best friend Mattie had given her, a mystery novel in which the young heroine solved crimes and just happened to receive her first kiss. Katie had been enthralled with the story, but before she could finish, Mam had confiscated the book and tossed it in the trash. Now Katie was relegated to picking apples, with Jacob watching her every move. Dot had hauled them to the orchard in the buggy and dropped them off. While Katie walked ahead, Jacob checked them in with Mrs. Zimmerman, who supplied them with bushel baskets, 2 wagons with hand pulls, and instructions on where to pick. Stop looking so dejected. Katie glanced over her shoulder to see him pulling both wagons behind him. I have better things to do than tromp around this orchard picking apples with you, she said. Like what? He smirked. Read an English romance book? It was a mystery novel. Katie defended herself, taking the handle of the 2nd wagon. Same thing. You're just jealous because I read better than you. Better at filling your head with useless words, maybe. He started down the row of trees. Mam says those books are trash. Katie scooped a rotten apple out of the grass and threw it, hitting him solidly in the back. Jacob spun, laughing. Katie couldn't help it. She laughed too. Her brother might be older, but he still liked to have fun on occasion, when he wasn't trying to boss her around anyway. Better not bite off more than you can chew, he warned. I can throw a lot harder than you. He had a point. Not that long ago, she'd been able to outrun him, throw the baseball farther than him, and out-wrestle him. But not now. Jacob was nearly a foot taller than her, and his muscles were the size of small hams. Of course, Katie knew he was too kind to ever hurt her. On the contrary, she was the one who'd been accused of possessing a mean streak. He motioned toward the far end of the orchard. I'll start a couple of rows over at the end, and we'll work our way toward each other. Glad to be rid of him, Katie watched him walk away, trying hard not to feel sorry for herself. It wasn't fair. Not only had Mam taken her book, but she'd ripped it in half. That had hurt. Worse, she wouldn't be able to return it to Mattie. At least Mam hadn't found the lip gloss she kept hidden in a sock in her drawer. Resigned, she dropped the wagon's handle to the ground, went to the nearest tree, and plucked a shiny ginger-cold apple off the branch, setting it carefully in the basket so as not to bruise it or nick the flesh. Around her, the late August day was glorious and warm, with a breeze that held a hint of autumn. She daydreamed as she worked, the one thing she was good at, it seemed. She entertained forbidden thoughts about the boy who had helped her dad and brother cut and bale hay a few weeks ago. Daniel Lapp was Jacob's age, a good worker, and he had the face of an angel, pretty eyes that sparkled when he smiled. It had been hot that day, and Mam had asked her to take lemonade to them out in the field. Daniel hadn't said a word to Katie, but he'd smiled when she handed him the glass. Her legs weren't quite steady when she walked back to the house. Later that night, she'd dreamed of him. She'd just twisted another apple off the branch when something hit her in the back, hard enough to hurt. Drawing back to defend herself from her marauding brother, Katie spun. "Mattie!" The Amish girl doubled over with laughter. "You should have seen your face, like you were under attack and you were going to beat the crap out of someone." The image struck Katie's funny bone, and for a full minute, the girl's laughter rang out. Mattie Erb had been her best friend for as long as she could remember. In the past, Katie had seen her at school, which made learning so much more tolerable, even though they'd gotten their knuckles rapped for speaking out of turn or laughing when they weren't supposed to. But the Amish only went to school through the 8th grade. Both girls had finished last year. Katie didn't get to see Mattie as often now. She missed those easy, carefree days. Mattie was funny and pretty and, like Katie, had a penchant for getting into trouble. They were a match made in heaven. "What are you doing here?" Katie asked. "Picking apples, same as you, dummy." Dropping a piece of fruit into her basket, Katie walked over to her friend. Mattie wore an Amish dress like the gray one Katie was wearing, but maroon, and an off-white cardigan with the sleeves pushed up to her elbows. Like most of the other Amish girls their age, they wore sneakers and matching organdy caps. "Mam needs 3 bushels for pies." Mattie tilted her head, her eyes sparking. "Is Jacob here?" Mattie had a crush on Katie's brother, though he wasn't the only boy she had her eye on. It was one of the reasons Mam didn't approve of their friendship. She said Mattie was boy crazy and wild. Of course, Katie loved her even more for it. "He's 2 rows over at the other end," Katie replied. "You're lucky to have such a cute brother," Mattie said breezily. "Cute like a pig, maybe." But the blues that had been weighing her down all morning began to lift. Now that Mattie was here, the day was looking up. "Have you seen anyone else we know?" Mattie asked. "No such luck." Tugging an apple from a branch, Katie checked it for worms and took a bite. "Just us boring girls." "Speak for yourself." Digging into her apron pocket, Mattie withdrew a tube of lipstick. "Peach berry dew is definitely not boring." Katie watched as her friend swiveled the tube and glided the lipstick over her mouth. It was the color of a ripe, wet peach. It looked good on Mattie, she thought. And not for the first time, Katie found herself wishing she were as pretty as Mattie. Hopefully, it wouldn't be too much longer before her figure filled out. "Where did you get it?" Katie asked. "Fox's Pharmacy. They've got the best colors." Wearing makeup was forbidden by the Ordnung, which made Katie wonder if Mattie had bought it, or if the lipstick had somehow found its way into her pocket. She didn't ask. Mattie offered the tube to Katie. "Try it." Katie shook her head. "Jacob will tell. So wipe it off before he sees you. He'll never know." Glancing toward the far end of the orchard and seeing no sign of her brother.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.